Good morning, students. Welcome back to St. Joseph's English Medium School, Vijaipur, 4th Standards, WhatsApp's Digital Learning Classes of Mathematics. Students, still now, we have completed lesson number 2. In the last video, we have completed the last exercise of the lesson number 2. In this lesson number 2, we have learned exercise 2.1, Indian system of numbering 6 and 7 digit numbers. 2.2, write the 6 and 7 digit numbers in standard forms. Exercise 2.3, international number system. Exercise 2.4, expanded notation. Exercise 2.5, rounding the numbers. These 5 exercises we have completed in the previous videos. Today we are going to begin the new lesson, that is lesson number 3. Lesson number 3 is Roman numerals. Here we are going to learn exercise 3.1. We are going to learn here understanding the Hindu Arabic system, introduction to Roman numerals, rules of writing Roman numerals. Today these things we are going to learn in this today's exercise. So, before understanding Roman numerals, let us understand what is Hindu Arabic system. Hindu Arabic system, it has 10 different symbols. These 10 symbols are very well known by you, because till now what numbers you are writing in your notebooks, they are called Hindu Arabic number. They include the symbol from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Using these symbols, we form the numbers. One or more symbols placed together form a number. Yes, you know very well. If you write one number, single digit, you will read a single number. If you take two digit number, you will include two numbers there. Three digit, four digit, five digit, six, seven digit, up to now you have learnt it. So, in the Arabic, Hindu Arabic system, we can include any number of symbols to any number. Each symbol has its place value. Remember, why Hindu Arabic system is very easy to understand? Because it has the place value. Each number will inform the place value of the digit. Like ones, tens, hundred, thousands, ten thousands, yes or no? Lakh, 10 lakh. These all are inform you in the Hindu Arabic system only. So let us take some example to understand. If you write single digit, we read directly that number. See here, 9. 9 will read it as single digit number. The next number which is appeared on your screen is 25. 2 and 5 are different digits. Together we are reading as 25. Why? Because it has two places. One is ones place, another is tens place. 20 plus 5 is 25. One more example. 786. 786, it is a 3-digit number that includes 700 plus 80 plus 6. Next number is 3259. Here it is a 4-digit number. It includes thousands number. 3000 plus 200 plus 50 plus 9. See, in Hindu Arabic system, this is the main advantage we are having. How many digits you can include to that number, it has place value for that numbers. So this is the what you have learned up to now in your number system. Today we are going to learn that entirely new concept. Let us see what that concept is. That is Roman numerals. What is Roman numerals? Roman numerals are the numbers that were used in the ancient Rome. In the Rome country, this number system was there, which employed the combination of letters from the Latin alphabet. Using the capital letters, they used to form the letters, numbers. Which are the alphabets they are used to form? Only 7 alphabet they will be having for the to write the numbers. Which are those? I, V, X, L, C, D and M. using these 7 alphabets, they is to represent the numbers are represented by combination of following symbols. Numbers are represented by putting the symbols in various combination. By using the combinations, they can form the different numbers. But there are certain rules to follow those numbers. Let us see what are the types to write the following Roman numerals. Here, it has only 7 symbols. As I told, only 7 alphabets are used to form the Roman numerals. They are I, V, X, L, C, D, and M. Each letter gives its respective value. So they all are capital letters. Remember, children, Roman numerals always written in the capital letters. You cannot write small letters here. So what is each symbol says? Capital I is 1, V is 5, X is 10, L is 50, C is 100, D is 500, and M is 1000. By using each symbol, we can write the Roman numbers. There is no symbol for 0. Remember, here we don't have concept of 0 here. Roman numerals do not follow the place value system. As we are using the alphabets, we don't have any place value system here. Now, with this, certain more things we have to follow the rules to write the Roman numerals. First is rules of writing the Roman numerals. What are the rules we have to follow while writing the numerals? Because remember, only 7 alphabets we are using. First rule is rule number 1. Rule of repetition. The symbol, first rule, the symbol I, X, C and M may be repeated maximum of 3 times. Remember, only these 4 alphabets we can repeat it for maximumly 3 times. Next rule, the symbol V, L, D. These 3, which are those V, L, G, never repeated. Means while writing the Roman numerals, only one time we can use V, L, D. The next rules, when the symbols is repeated twice or thrice, its value is multiplied by 2 or 3 respectively. Remember, only twice and thrice when it is repeated, then only we can multiply that value. With the example, we can understand it. As I told children, only I, X, C, M can be repeated. So what are those example by doing this? See, the capital I represent 1, capital X represent 10, C represents 100, and M represents thousands. If I write 2 times I, that means 2 ones are 2. If I write 3 times I, that is 3. Similarly, if I write 2x, that is 2 tens are 20. 3x is equal to 3 times of tens, that is 30. 2 c's, 200 2s are 200. 3 c's, 100 3s are 300. Maximum 3 is there, see children here. Then M is thousands. 2M, 2000s are 2000. 3M, 1000 3s are 3000. Like this, we have to multiply and write the value of the numbers. Now, second rule. What are the second rule of the Roman numeral? First rule is rule of repetition. Which symbols we can repeat here? Only I, X, C and M. These 4 alphabets we can repeat up to that to maximum only 3 times, children. Not 4 or 5 times. Only 3 maximum. We can repeat for 1 or 2. But not more than 3. Rule 2, rule of addition. If a symbol of a smaller value is written to the right of a symbol of a higher value, we add the smaller value to a greater value. At the right side, whatever value for the higher symbol you write, that will be added to that number. Let us see this with the examples. First, I'll take one example. Here, V, I. V represents 5. I represent 1. Because here 2 I's written, so 5 plus 1 plus 1. This means V double I is equal to 7. X is 10. To that I am including the I. That means 10 plus 1, 11. Double X I. 2X means 20. I means 1, 21. XV. See here. To the bigger value, I am including the smaller value. So, right side of the number I am writing here. So, that number should be added to that bigger alphabet. That is X plus V. XV is 10 plus 5, 15. LX. L is, as I said, 50. X is 10. 50 plus 10 is equal to 60. See here, L double X I, 50 plus 10 60 plus 10 70 plus I 71. CL, C is 100, L is 50, so 150. DC, D is 500, C is 100, 500 plus 100 is 600. Next, MC, M is 1000 and C is 100, 1000 and 100. So this is the method to doing the rules of addition. Now let us see what is the next rule. Rule of subtraction. If a symbol of smaller value is the left of a symbol of higher value, we subtract the smaller value from the higher value. Means, in the value of the higher symbol value, we are going to left side. What smaller value will be written, that will be subtracted. The symbol V, L, D cannot be subtracted. Remember, we cannot subtract V, L, D. Only we can subtract I, X, and C are used to subtract. Which are those? I, X, C. There are just six combinations of like this. Example, let us take the example. See, we know it, 5, it's the highest value. Before V, I written the I, that means in the 5, we have to minus the 1. 5 minus 1 is equal to 4. X, the number is IX. X is 10. Before the X, I written the I, means left side of the number, higher value. Then 10 minus 1 is equal to 9. XL, L is 50. Before the L, I written X, that means 50 minus 10, 40. XC, C is 100. In this C, I am going to minus the 10. So, it is 90. X is 90. CD. D is 500. In that 500, I am going to minus 100 because C is 100. So, it is 400. CM. M is what? 1000. Minus 100. It is 900. This is the method of rule of subtraction. Children, when you start writing the numbers, automatically this concept will be understood by you. When you see this, you will get little bit confusion. I know it. But when we write up to numbers from 1 to 100, that idea of rules of addition and rules of subtraction will be thoroughly understood by you. Let's see the next part of the lesson. Let us do exercise number 3.1. Question number 1. Write the corresponding Roman numerals in the space below. So, some numbers they are given in the question number A. What are the numbers? Yes, they are given 1 to 10. Let us write. As I told, very easy. 1 means, what is the Roman numeral? Capital I, only single I. 2 means 2 I's. 3 means 3 I's. Finish. Now 4. Remember, for the 4 we cannot write 4 I's. Why? What is the rules of the Roman numerals? A symbol can be repeated maximumly 3 times. Now what we have to do? We have to follow here. Subtraction, rules of subtraction. What we have to do? First we have to write V, then we have to write, first we have to write I, then we have to write the V. That means 4. Because in the 5, 1 is minus, it is equal to 4. Now 5 is V itself. 6. So 6 means V, I. That is, V is 5, I is 1. 5 plus 1 is 6. V2I, that is 7. V3I, 8. Again, 3 I's are over here. Again, what we have to do here? What we have to do? Till now, to the maximum value, we have added the smaller values. Now, again, we have to follow the subtraction method. What is? First, we have to write the bigger value minus in that smaller value. That is IX. IX is 10. So, what we have to do? IX is 9. In the 10, I is minus, that is 1, it equal to 9. 10 is X. Question number 2. That is, see here, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 100. 10 is what, children? X. 20 is 2 times X, 2X. 30 is 3 times X. Again, same problem arises here. After 3x, we cannot write 4x. What we have to do? As we know, L is 50. In that 50, we have to minus the x. So, means XL is the 40. Now, 50 is L. 60 is LX. 70 is L double X. L is 50. 2x means 20. 50 plus 20 is 70. L triple X, that is 53x, 30, 80. XC, in 100 we are minusing 10, it is become 90. C is 100. Got the idea, children? Now it is looking easy for you? I hope so. Let us do question number C of question number 1. They are given 5, 15, 25, 35, 45, 50, 65, 75, 85, 95. We know it. What is 5? V. Good. 15 is X and V. Because X is 10, V is 5. So 15. 25, 2XV. 35, 3XV. 45, already above we had written XL, it is 40. So, XLV is equal to what? 45. In X, in L, we are minusing 10. That becomes 40. Then, for that 40, we are including 5. XL5 is, XLV is 45. LV, 55. LXV, 65. LXXV, 75. LXXV, 85. XCV is 95. This is what we have completed the question number 1. Now let us do the question number 2. What is question number 2? Write the Roman numerals in your notebook from 1 to 100. So you will become totally perfect now. Now already these numbers we have written. 1 is 1 I, single I, capital I, that is 2, 2 I's. 3, 3 I's, 4, IV, 5, V, 6, VI, 7, V double I, 8 VII 9 IX 10 is X. Now let us see 11 to 20. Children, X is 10. To that, if you include I, that becomes 11. Like this, we have to write the 11 to 20. 11, X double I, 12, X triple I, 13, XIV, 14, XV, 15, XVI, 16, XV double I, 17, XV triple I, 18, XIX, 19, double X is 20. Now 21 to 20, 30. Double XI, double X2, double X2Is, double X3Is, double XIV, 24, double XV is 25. Like this, we have to write 25, 21 to 30. Now, triple X is 30, 31 to 40. Triple XI is 31, triple XV is 35, XL is 40. 41 to 50, XL is 40, XLI is 41, XL triple I is 43, XL VI is 46, XL V triple I is 48, XL IX is 49, L is 50. Now let write the 51 to 100. 51 LI, 54 LIV, 56 LIVI, 59 LIX, 60 LX. Now 61 to 70, LXI is 61, LX double I is 62, LXV double I is 67, LXIX is 69, L double X is 70. Now 71 LX, L double XI is 71, L double XV is 75, L double XV triple I is 78, L triple X is 80. 81 to 90, 81 is L triple XI, L triple XV is 85. Now biggest Roman numeral is writing Roman numeral is L triple X V triple I. Here all C 88 it is. L triple X V triple I 88. XC is 90. 91 to 100. XCI is 91. XC double triple I is 93. XC V double I is 97, XC IX is 99, C is 100. Children, here they are told only write the Roman numerals, but I have written along with Hindu Arabic number Roman numerals. Why? Because you can easily read the both the numbers and you can easily identify this Roman numerals. I hope this concept is, this question number 1 and 2 is completely and thoroughly understood by you. So while writing, please children, say and write the numbers. Okay, say Hindu Arabic number, then say the alphabets also, then only you will understand the Roman numerals. Now you have to open the your classwork. There what you have to do, children, new page, you have to open the new page, write lesson number 3, Roman numerals, introduction to Roman numerals. Write those points. It has only 7 symbols. Which are those 4 points I told? No. Then also write the all 7 symbols, place respective values also. Then afterwards you begin the exercise number 3.1. As this lesson is consist of only one exercise, so I will make 2 parts of the video. Because here in this video I taught only question number 1 and 2 to you. The remaining questions will be taught to you in the next video. First question is, write the corresponding Roman numerals in the space below. So write this like this, making the chart, use the dark pencil to write. So in your classwork and homework, you have to write very much neatly, because many of them are writing very light. In the photos, I am unable to see your handwriting. Please write it little bit dark, okay? So question number 1 and 2, write it in your classwork. In the next video, we are going to write question number 3 and 4 of exercise number 3.1. I hope this is the new concept. If you have any doubts, please give me a call or write the message to my WhatsApp number. Please watch the video again and again, then only understand it. Till the next video, in this video we have completed question number 1 and 2 of exercise number 3.1. The next video will be question number 3 and 4 of exercise number 3.1. Till the next video, children, goodbye, take care, stay home, stay safe. Thank you for watching the video, children. See you.